So welcome back. We're here at Devoxx with Seth Ladd, and we're here to talk about Dart. So welcome, Seth, to Devoxx. This is your first time.
This is awesome. Yeah, thanks for having me.
Working well for you. So you just presented on Dart. So for those people that have been living in a cave or under a rock, can you give us a quick intro on Dart and how, you know, you call this a new language for the web? And it's one thing that I found interesting is that it's meant to be enterprising. So if you can elaborate on that, I'd love to hear you.
Well, sure. The quick version of Dart is one of our goals is to help more developers come to the web. And you've got experienced developers on platforms like Java and ActionScript, C++, C Sharp, that really love the exciting power of HTML5 in the modern browser, but would like to build those apps in a language and with a set of tools that feels more familiar, productive, and powerful to them.
Okay.
And so this is certainly what attracted me as someone who's come from kind of the Java structured background and moved to web programming. I think it's going to attract a lot of developers as well. Yes.
So the language part is meant to be unsurprising. So do you want to say why it's unsurprising?
Yeah. There's two main core tenets of the Dart project. One is that it has to be recognizable and familiar. The second is that it must compile to logical and sane JavaScript. But in terms of the language being familiar, this is not the opportunity to develop the world's next Haskell, for instance. This is an opportunity for us to, again, reach out to the existing legions of developers on all these different platforms and say, here's something that you can jump on very easily, very quickly, you feel safe and comfortable with, and still deploy to the modern web with HTML5. And so it's very... it was a critical decision at the early parts of the project to make something people can, within an hour or two, get up and running.
Right. So, as people have understood, I think it's not just a language; it's a platform.
Mm-hmm.
So there's the language. There are tools around it. Maybe testing tools.
Yep.
I mean, can you?
Certainly. Yeah. You're absolutely right. It's much more than just the language, although that's an interesting part of it. But we also have things like a full editor with code completion and refactoring and quick fixes and debugging and outlines. Again, trying to make a familiar toolability story to the developers out there. We also have a package manager, pub, so you can discover and install and update your third-party dependencies. We have a wide range of libraries that come built into the SDK. Certainly the core libraries like collections and dates and stuff, but also the libraries like unit testing and mocks and JSON, and the list goes on and on. So all this comes out of the box as well. We also have a virtual machine. So you can run Dart programs natively on a Dart VM, which is really important when you do your development cycle. You want to just write some code and hit reload, and it just pops right up in your web page. This is the kind of experience that web developers have had since the beginning of time, and it's fantastic for iteration. Mm. And then we also have a compiler to JavaScript, so that when you're done testing your app on the virtual machine and you're ready to ship to production browsers that don't have Dart VM, you can run Dart to JS, the compiler to JavaScript, and then deploy that out and actually run Dart across the modern web on modern web browsers.
Awesome. So if we step back and we look at HTML5, which is, you know, this buzzword which encompasses a lot of different technologies and their frameworks and JavaScript, such as, you know, Backbone, or there are so many of them, and Angular is probably a very popular one. Can you try to position and explain how they relate to Dart, to a platform like Dart?
Well, sure, and I think it's a really good sign that the JavaScript community is now embracing these more structured ways to build web apps. As we need to continue to innovate and deliver the really fantastic, high-fidelity, complex, silky-smooth experiences that users demand, we need more structure, and I think we need the frameworks out there. So that's really cool. So you mentioned Backbone. Backbone is a simple way to kind of structure your models and views. Angular puts a lot of the data binding into your actual HTML, which is really cool. But ultimately, I mean, at the end of the day, they're still running on top of JavaScript, which for a ton of people is fantastic. But for developers familiar in other languages, we want to give them a fantastic web development experience. And so we talked about the language and libraries and tools, but we're also building to help them actually use it to build modern web apps. We're building out web components capabilities.
Okay.
And this gives you the two-way data binding, the encapsulation of styles, behavior, and structure, the ability for you to extend HTML classes, like you can extend button and create fancy button, create your own custom elements.
Right.
And this is all stuff being baked into the web platform today by the browser vendors, but we can use our compiler, the JavaScript, to actually make the future of web components available today and deploy in modern browsers today. So it's really, really cool.
Great. So talking about browsers and maybe future browsers, When can we expect something that actually comes with a Dart VM? You know, maybe performance-wise, that is a great motivation.
Yeah, the VM is a great development and debugging story, very quick iterations.
Yeah.
But there's also a performance story there as well. We use a system called Snapshots that have about a 10x performance increase for startup time because it doesn't have to reparse the source code. It can start from the binary serialized snapshot. But there's also a story around just the raw computation performance of the Dart VM. We're already beating V8 on a bunch of different benchmarks. And
you know, it's about V8. It's the same people.
Yeah, that's a really cool thing, right? If anybody knows speed, it's these original developers that did V8 and Hotspot, and now they're working on Dart. I mean, that's a good sign. But it's super early there, but we have good optimistic hopes about the performance getting better. And as far as actually landing in browsers, we still have work to do. We have a build of Chromium with a Dart VM in it. So it all works today.
Yep.
But we have more stability work to go to prove to the Chrome guys that this is something that they want to put in. And then as far as the other browsers, I think the important thing to remember is Dart's success is really, it's tied to developer success. So if developers using Dart develop really awesome HTML5 modern apps and they're compiling to JavaScript with Dart, then that's a win. You know, if Dart just brings in more developers to the web platform, that's good for everybody.
Right. So so you mentioned performance. Can you talk about maybe adoption and where we are in the roadmap? So Milestone 1 has shipped. Does it mean like the language is actually stable completely now?
It's pretty stable, yeah. So about a year ago, we had a technology preview, and we listened to a lot of feedback, and we loved the community feedback. And then we had the M1 launch, which was our first kind of public beta of the SDK.
Okay.
And the language is fairly stable. We don't anticipate any backwards breaking changes unless we run into some like massive bug.
Okay.
We do anticipate new language features as long as they don't break backwards compatibility. And then the future milestone releases as we kind of march towards a 1.0, we'll be thinking of working on things like maturity of the platform, adding in a couple of new language features, better performance, library refactoring. So we're not at 1.0 yet, but the M1 was a great milestone. It's like, hey, developers, you can now come check out Dart, and we're not going to rip up the language on you underneath. Yeah.
So we're looking at 6-week cycles releasing updates?
I'm not exactly sure what we've committed to, but it does look like that we're going to have like a Chrome-esque or Firefox-esque fast iteration cycle and get these new releases out to developers. We do push a new build every week, which is really great, but I think the milestones are going to come pretty quickly, which is nice.
Okay, great. Any final thoughts on you know, what the next year will look like and what you want developers, other than try Dart, what kind of feedback are you looking for?
Yeah, we're really looking for feedback on web components.
Now's a good time.
Yeah. Web components is a big thing that we're working on. And again, this is going to come down the web platform anyway, but we're making this available to developers thanks to our compiler to JavaScript. And just keep working on libraries that publish into pub, our package manager.
Okay.
I mean, this has helped really everyone get up and running by, I mean, what's the best productivity enhancement? That is not to write code. So if you can use other people's code and use other packages, it's fantastic. Yeah, so give those a shot. Join us on the mailing list. We're on Google+, and we're an open source project, and so you can jump right into the issue tracker and just file bugs.
Right.
It's all good.
Okay, Stack Overflow, mailing list.
Stack Overflow is really good. Stack Overflow probably preferred, but numerous ways
wherever,
to get a hold of us.
People are.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We're very eager to hear the feedback.
Great. Well, I guess that's all the time we have for it. Thanks, Seth, and good luck for the rest.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.